Hello there, my name is Chris Palmer, and in today's Google My Business SEO video, what I'd like to share with you is what I call Google My Business post-mirroring. Now, as you know, I've gone through multiple other tutorials regarding mirroring, site mirroring, content mirroring with the Google My Business listings. Now, what I want to walk you through today, first and foremost, is going to be a draw out. It's going to be visual because I'm a visual learner. You might be as well. And I'll put that here on the whiteboard. And then I will literally walk you through step by step on how you can then start doing some post mirroring based on your website's content. Now, the premise is quite simple, but the effectiveness is absolutely out of this world. So of course, I do not want to waste any time. Let me go ahead and get directly into the visual diagram, and then I'll walk you through the tutorial step by step. All right, so let me go ahead and show you exactly what I'm talking about. So first and foremost, you're going to have your GMB. All right, so you'll have your GMB entity. So it's GMB. We could just put Google My Business. So Google My Business. All right. And then over here on this side, we'll make the barrier red. All right. And then on this side, what we're going to have is our website. All right. So it's going to be your website. All right. So this is yourwebsite.com. So we have our Google My Business and our website.com. Now, like you already know, Google wants us, just like within our content, they want us to show users what we're actually showcasing within the SERPs or within the search engine results page. So much like with our content, what we're giving them to our title and our H1, they want the same. It's just like that within our Google My Business. Now, like I've gone through before in the past, where you're stacking up your services and your posts, they're matching and mirroring, and then you're mirroring them over to your website. Whatever your services and products are, it's the same terminology, the same wording, the same descriptions. You're mirroring it to the website. We want to take that same exact concept and utilize that within our posts. So I have these two posts, all right? So I have my post here for Google stacking, and then I have my posting structure over here inside of my Google My Business. All right. So that's what I mean by website and Google My Business. Now, what I want to get into is this. On my website, I've gone in and I've created, all right, I've created a particular post. For this example, it's going to be Google stacking. All right. Now, within my Google stacking, I've also created some content. All right, so there's going to be some content, there's going to be headers, right? Your paragraph text, you have heading two, a little bit of paragraph text, maybe an image, and the list goes on and on. Now, most notably, what I want you to take note of is the wording that's at inside the, under the first heading or under your first H2, and I also want you to take note of whatever images you are using inside of your website within your most recent post or within one of your pages. It's really irrelevant. So if we have our title, all right, we have our content. I'm sure you have 1,000+ words on the page, but we're most notably concerned with 100 to 200 words, all right, most notably. And then along with that, the image that you have used inside of your website and inside of your post or on your page. Now, what I mean by post mirroring, just like I do for products and services, just like I did for the website, the way I'm titling it, the way I'm listing out my categories, my services, my locations, just like I mirrored over for Google My Business, I did this publicly in a past video, it's the same thing for the posts. Whatever I'm showing over here, I want to be able to show over there on Google My Business. So exact same thing. I create a post. All right. We're going to go over to Google My Business and we create a post. I just created a new page. Now I'm going to create a post to share locally with my fans, my users, so I can expand my reach. This is what GMB says. So within this post, we're going to take the exact same title. All right. So it's going to be the same title. All right, so we're gonna write title here, T-I-T-L-E, the same title. So this is gonna mirror over to here, all right? That same little piece of content, all right? Now that same content that I use, not the entire article because Google only allows so much, but at least a blurb, like 100, 250 words is perfectly fine. So we're gonna match and mirror that right over to here. On top of that, an image, my headline image, we wanna take one of the same images that we utilized over on our Google My Business, or we wanna use that on our Google My Business that we used on the page. So pick one. So if you utilize the hero image or perhaps a first image right after the H1, great, that's the image that you wanna go ahead and use within your Google My Business post. So the same image. So I guess the image would be up here, right? So there's the image. Now let's talk about the links. All right, on your page, on your website page, you're probably going to list probably the GMB with the CID link. You might have a map embed, but no matter what, whatever post that's matching and mirroring, we want to use that URL to learn more within our Google My Business post. So we're going to use the URL of the website. All right. So whatever we used here. So let's go ahead and put this in the practice of exactly what I'm talking about. So let me go ahead and walk you through that. Let's say that this is a post that I just created. We have Google authority stacking. So here's our image. All right. So we're gonna go ahead and copy the image address. All right, so I think I still have that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go inside of here and we're going to create a, what should we do? Should we do an update or an offer? That's going to be up to you. We're going to add our photo. What photo are we going to use? Well, we want to use the exact same photo that we used within that post. So I have to go down here and find that. So here it is. So we're going to take, again, the same exact image. All right. What is this? This is Google stacking Chris Palmer Marketing. And then what are we gonna do? We wanna learn more, right? It's gonna be the HTTPS. Now, obviously you might wanna add a little more. I'm just doing this for sake of example. You might wanna make this a little bit longer. Again, I would take a blurb. This is for sake of example here. Chris Palmer Marketing, it's highly relevant. Google stacking, where are we learning more? We're taking this exact same address. We're gonna copy it. We're gonna go ahead and put it into here. All right, and we will go ahead and publish this. Now, in an ideal situation, on this page, I would have an embed of my Google My Business listing with the CID or an embed of the actual map. But again, this is gonna be completely up to you. So this is Google My Business SEO post mirroring. My name is Chris Palmer. If you have any further questions related to Google My Business, local SEO, digital marketing, Facebook ads, Google ads, YouTube ads, really anything at all, always feel free. Go ahead and ask in the comments below. I answer all questions, anything that's relevant to this topic or anything else I talk about. And I look forward to seeing you in the next Google My Business SEO posts video. Have a wonderful day.